game number 35. It's the first plate semi-final. Please put your hands together and welcome back to the pitch, the Philippines and China.
So great.
So plate semi-final time, Philippines taking on the People's Republic of China. Philippines in the blue, China in the yellow. And it's Jason Lynch who finds himself trapped inside the 22. Oh, risky ball there, and China have grasped onto that. Now they're on attack. They've looked very impressive so far this weekend, the Chinese, but a little knock on at the base by Feng Liwei. Referee for this game, Aaron Littlewood, based in Manila now. Good to see his partner Dion in the stand. Team. Here's Jason Lynch. He's got a bit of space. Tacklers, but then again, just throwing the ball away. Oh, and Jake Letts decided to puts his boot to it. And they're coming back for a penalty to China here. Taking their time and setting this one up. Of course, it's 12 o'clock on the dot and 30-odd degrees, so no need to hurry. Boheny dishes out some physical medicine there, and they hold the Chinese player up. He's getting no help from his teammates there. Surely there were three men just standing there watching. And now the referee has to explain the laws to the Chinese players. That was an unusual situation where the Philippines players held him up nicely. What he needed there were his teammates to come through and give him a bit of aid. Didn't come though. Letts to Holgate. And they're really Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid in this Philippines outfit. Calling the shots, Holgate goes in. That's right. And so it's Sean Lynch this time who grabs the ball. It's a better pass to Boheny. Boheny tries to get around the outside, can't do it. Nice work, although he's escorted back into his own half by Liu Guanjian. Manages to get the ball eventually. Letts gets smashed, but brave work from him. He gets the ball over his head to Holgate. Again, some good work in the tackle from China, and they have the penalty. The Chinese players want the ball quickly, and the Philippines team march back 10 metres. Jason Lynch. So the Philippines players weren't sure of where the offside line was. It's welcome back to Di Reis. Di, great to have you back.
Hi, Mike. Good to be back in the air-conditioned room, yeah. He's reaching some temperatures out there now.
Some good linking work here from the Chinese team. Up to Chen Kaiwen. Oh, took his eye off the ball there. Liu Chao. So Philippines chance to break out. Oh, breaks down though. It's Tim Young who's out there for one of the first times this tournament.
Tense first 4 minutes, Mike. The temperatures are reaching 34, 35 degrees out there now. It's the midday sun. It's real tough conditions, but real pressurized first 4 minutes.
Just to talk you through the plate semi-finals, it's Philippines and China, and then we have Singapore, Malaysia coming up next for the plate competition. Oh, lovely snipe away from the base of the scrum, and he got round Lynch too. In fact, it's Holgate who was beaten on the outside. So first blood to China in this cup semi-final. I think it's Feng Li Wei. Just do a number check on his way back.
First try of the match, scored by China.
Liu Chao.
By the lead with conversion to come.
Hydration is very important in this environment, Dai.
Oh, he was the important both during the game and pre and post. Depleting, taking a 20%, 25% of your ability to perform out of the game. So huge, huge as they build through and work towards the finals at the end of the day.
7-0 to China. Wang Jiwan Hua to restart. Oh, a bit of a doubt on who was taking that ball. Wolf finally goes back and then smashes somebody in the tackle because he's frustrated he couldn't get that ball. Holding on from Jake Lett. So another try-scoring opportunity here for China. Just a minute to go in the first half. Here's Chen Kaiwen. A nice clean quick ball to Feng. Oh, and right thing from Feng, but just the timing on the run from Wang Wei stopped in his tracks. Yeah?
My China possesses some great athletes right across the board at the moment, but that's a great example of why they just can't step up to the semi-final slots. They're probably up there with the top four teams in this competition, but lack that composure and final execution.
Pretty scruffy line-out throw from Lett, so it falls into Chinese hands. They look to go blind, Littlewood. Come back for the not straight at the line-out, so China with a chance to blow this lead out to 2-0 if they can touch down just before half-time. There's the half-time hooter. So Feng will put the ball into this scrum. In fact, it's Liu Chao, and Feng is at first receiver now. A little untidy at the set piece, so another shot here for Liu Chao. Too deep in their formation, the Chinese backs. Wolf gets his boot to it to slow it down yet once more, but China won't be too concerned. They've got their hands on the throat of the Philippines here.
Big play here. Philippines need to defend this, going to take themselves into the second half of a chance. Big play both ways.
Looking for support, and he gets it too. China under the shadow of the posts here at half time. Again, another penalty holding on, and surely Aaron Littlewood must be thinking in terms of yellow cards at the breakdown. We saw this Philippines team yesterday giving away a lot of penalties at the
breakdown. Yeah, frustrating. They tend to focus on keeping the continuity away.
Feng Li Wei with a quick tap. He's a jinky-jivey runner. Has he got downward pressure? Yes, he has. So a reward for China just before half-time. It's Feng Li Wei with the touchdown and a conversion to come.
Critical score. Philippines in it to play for second half, but that's a big score just on half time. Taking a score away to 12-0 and probably 14.
Successful.
They have the conversion. It's 14-0 at half time. China over the Philippines.
We enter the half time with China leading the Philippines by 14-0.
Yeah.
When Hong Kong won the Rugby World Cup sevens in 3 years, and they make the movie, you know who to go for, right?
Olympic gold.
Yeah. Well, it's a mountain to climb here for the Philippines. 14 points down, 7 minutes to go.
So we're ready for the second half.
What we're seeing, Mike, already in this temperature zone, this huge swing second half in games, where it's to take a team away or to bring a team back in. The Philippines can hold in there now. Cross in, there we go. There's the break that might help the Philippines pull themselves back straight into this game early in the second half.
Well, Henny takes it quickly.
And
of course, yeah. Liu has to get himself back 10 metres. He did very well there, sort of shadowed the runner, although Littlewood's having none of it. He did influence Bueni's line, so they'll come back for that penalty. Fung Lee Wei there, I thought he found his way through. Some nice footwork, but Philippines on the attack now, their chance. Jason Lynch up to Holgate. He's dragged down just inside the 22. Sean Lynch gets it out to Andrew Wolf, who finds the ball over the back of his head. So a little knock on both ways. Scrum, China. There's such a logjam in the middle of this Asian Seven Series table, isn't it? The competition is so close between teams ranked number 4 to number 9 or 10, really. It's
yeah,
great.
You know, the Philippines, China were up in the top 4 for season before last, but it's an indication, Mike, of the strength in Asian rugby and how people investing, countries investing in their sevens programs, and as a result, the top 8 now, there's some good quality stuff being played. But disappointing control there by the Philippines. They had an ideal opportunity to pull themselves back into this game in the first minute of the second half.
Wahini has some sort of gold medallion hanging around his neck, so he's had to throw that away over the sideline. The lucky charm's gone. Hopefully that won't affect his performance too much. Good competition at the scrum, but China do get it back. Fung. Floppy pass, that one.
This is where, you know, you can see the set play being implemented by China irrespective of what happens with the defence. And I think this is the thing that, you know, doesn't take him to the next level. Like, trying to play a narrow side that didn't exist, back into traffic, and then a wild pass. And, you know, at a time where they should be controlling the game, 14-0 up, just pushing the ball through the hands to their speedsters out wide. And this is why, I think, but this is a young team. This is a young China team, a new team. I'm sure they'll work hard with them over the next 6 months to a year under the new management team to get those kind of errors out of their game.
So an important play here for the Philippines. Letts gets the ball cleanly to Holgate. Sean Lynch is a strong runner. Outside break. to Kenny Stern, I think that is, out in the wing. Lynch with a little interference there from a Chinese hand. And Timothy Young, Vincent Young, decides to probe with a kick. Waheny is taken out after he's kicked forward. So what will we see here? A timeout. I think the ball may have been going dead, so this will be an interesting call. Vincent Young with an interesting kick there, and Waheny chasing it. Full-blooded run to the line, had to tow it ahead. Was the Chinese player within his rights to tackle him, assuming that Waheny may grab possession?
I don't think a penalty try would be awarded. I think that you'd award a penalty try, maybe. Interesting. Don't think it was a certain try being scored because of the kick ahead. Yes. Certainly a yellow card and maybe a penalty, I would say, Mike, but it's pretty harsh if it's a penalty try. But it does a penalty try.
Well, high drama here. So seven points available. Yes, the conversion goes over, so 14 points to 7.
It's the breaks you need as players and coaches. Decisions like that go for you. It's great. And they've got 2 minutes now playing against six guys. And as we said earlier in the half, these second halves in his heat can swing on a decision, on a poor decision by the player to take the man out when it really was a...
Always a hard decision as a defender, isn't it? You're never sure whether the guy's going to grasp the ball with his hands, toe it ahead, and obviously timing's crucial there too. So China down to six men. Kai Wen grabs the kickoff. Fung.
Critical that China hold on to the
pressure
now
here. Smothering defence.
Yeah, great pressure by the Philippines. This is the name of the game now, Mike, is that the Philippines need to pressurise the ball. They need that ball back in hand as quickly as they can. Great play by China now.
Getting it into
space.
On to
the ball.
Good attack. Oh, again, just hands not ready for the catch. I don't know, sometimes you just think they lack a readiness.
Yeah.
Chao Zhang not ready for the pass. Lovely little ball from Jiang Niwei.
1 minute into the sin bin, and the Philippines are going to get an opportunity to attack off this scrum. 7 versus 6. Big play for the Philippines.
Unopposed at scrum half here, Letts, as the Chinese scrum half falls back into the back line. So Holgate. Now it's Stern. Sean Lynch. Oh, and the ball pops out of his hand. So advantage China. Big strong tackle from Jake Letts. Tackling above his weight there, Letts.
Well, I think now China have done enough in terms of holding on to possession for these 2 minutes, and I'm sure they'll be back to full complement.
Advantage here for China too, so they'll take this one quickly, surely. In fact, no, they won't, of course. They'll slow it down, punt for touch, and sap up the clock.
And good decision as well, mate.
Welcome back Liu Wanjian in about 30 seconds. Strapping forward.
Lynch unfortunately turning the ball over at a critical attacking moment for the Philippines. With China down to six men. So
yeah, now he's back, Liu. So back to 7 China. They managed to escape that one without giving away any more points. And just in time for a line out, 10 metres out from the Philippines line. Just a shortage of balls here at the Hong Kong Football Club all of a sudden. That one going onto the racetrack down at this beautiful Happy Valley setting. And it's not what we need in the hot sun to wait for 30 seconds, but the ball boys doing their best, I'm sure. The ball finally arrives, so we're on with play here. Only 2 minutes to go, clock restarts. China 14-7 ahead. Short one to the front. Now it's out to Wong Jianhua, who steps nicely inside Holgate and goes in unopposed under the posts to wrap this one up for China.
Great performance. It was in a balance for 2 or 3 minutes there, Mike, mid second half, but great composure shown by China to play the clock down in that 2 minute sin bin situation. And I think now that's probably sealed the Philippines' fate.
So the next semi-final will be between Singapore and Malaysia. That'll be an interesting clash as well. Singapore were dismissed by Hong Kong. Malaysia had a tight clash against Sri Lanka. So just a minute left of this game. Nice high kickoff, and it's Ned Stevenson who's back after his red card yesterday for the run in the last few seconds of this game. China just contend here to hold on to the ball, but they've been penalised, going off their feet at the breakdown. So Philippines with a chance to Holgate, tapping ahead, a bit untidy, but manages to get the ball back. Sean Lynch. Out to Kenneth Stern. Again, just looking for the space here, but it's Boheny who almost captured the ball. Little knock on, though. So you'd imagine China will just reset the scrum and wrap it up till the end of the game. They showed some good management decisions in this match, especially during the yellow card period.
The combination of Sean Lynch and Stern in the mid out on the wing just hasn't clicked in this game, and unfortunately at critical times it's broke down. Created the first try, awesome space, but unfortunately that understanding has broken down.
Now it's Holgate who latches onto this ball, and oh, he's shown some great soccer skills here, Gareth Holgate, to put them under pressure. But the Chinese players, casually as you like, Liu Guanzhan, the man who got the yellow card, just kicks it dead, and that will be the end of the game. So China with a victory over the Philippines in this plate semi-final, 21-7.
China 21, Philippines 7. China move through to the plate final. Some thanks to our sponsors. The title sponsor, RS Components, our official partners, Pinnacle, Event Canopies Asia, Seller, Master Wines.
Do you want to do this game, man? I'll just have a breather and then I'll get into the cup semis, yeah? Yes, of course, please. Malaysia, Singapore.
Gilbert, Andy, Cookery, Thomas,
yep.
And so we move on to our second plate semi-final. Let's find out who's going to beat China in the final. Please put your hands together and give a warm
thanks, Mike. Mark the diaries in the commentary, the unprofessional commentary filling in on the odd occasions. So don't expect.